Now that we've enabled our Django admin, let's go ahead and test it. Okay, so we're going to test the Django admin by starting the Python development server that comes with Django. So minimize Atom and head over to the Git Bash or terminal window. From the Git Bash or terminal window, we need to start the development server. So type python manage.py run server, and then we want to listen on all IP addresses. So type 0.0.0.0 and colon port 8080 and hit enter to start the server. Okay, so now our server's up and running. Let's load the Chrome browser up and let's head over to 127.0.0.1 port 8080. Now, at this location, we still see the same screen as we saw the last time we ran the server. We need to add /admin to the end of our URL to head over to the Django admin page. Okay, so now we see this login page for the Django administration. We need to log in with the credentials of the user we created earlier on in the last two lessons. So type the email address that you entered when you created the super user. Mine was mark@londonappdeveloper.com. And the password, which was for me, awesome, with a capital A, one. And hit enter to log in. Okay, so now we're logged in to the Django administration page. You can see there's three sections here. One is auth token, one is authentication and authorization, and another one is profiles API. These are different apps that we have enabled in our Django project. So these two top ones, the auth token and authentication and authorization, are apps that are provided, that are built into Django. So they're included in the Django framework. The app that we created is the Profiles API app. And this is our user profiles model, which we created earlier on. If you click on that, it will take you to the list of users that are registered in the system. So you can see that there's only one user here, and that's my super user that we created earlier. So if you click on that, you'll see all of the details. This is the password hash. This is the time we last logged in, and it has all of the details here. So the email address, the name, is active, is staff, and is super user. So you can see the benefits of the Django admin, because by writing very little code, just a few lines of code, we can have a working website that interfaces with our database and with our models. So it really does save you a lot of time when you're working with projects. Okay, so that's how you test the Django admin. Finally, let's commit our changes to Git. We're gonna start a new Git window or a new Git bash window or terminal. And we're gonna head over to our project. And we're gonna type git add any extra files, and we're going to type git commit -am, and we're going to give it the message enabled the Django admin for the user profile model. Enter to commit that, and there you go. So that's how you enable the Django admin. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video useful, and I'll see you in the next lesson.